For truth and diversity, come to Radio Simi.
Hey everyone, welcome to Radio Simi. I'm your host, Aleyah Ewing.
And I'm your guest, co-host, Linnea Chandler.
This week, we'll be interviewing local musician, Matt Anthony.
We are always looking for ways for people to join our team, so if you want to help and get to know our community better, check out our website under the tab About Us.
We'll also be going over the latest news and some more Simi Valley updates. Here's some updates about what's going on in Simi Valley and the greater area. The Simi Sunrise Rotary Club is having their first drive-in concert with Queen Nation. They'll be performing on April 2nd on the corner of Stearns and LA. You can find more information at rotaryclubofsimisunrise.org. Allies for Black Americans is having a Stretch and Breathe virtual event live every Saturday morning. By joining the event, you'll learn how to use breathwork to be better allies. It's at 7:45 a.m., and you can find more information, including the Zoom link, on their Facebook page. There's a candlelight vigil tonight past midnight at 12:45 a.m. for Breonna Taylor. 12:45 a.m. was Breonna Taylor's official time of death. It will take place at 12:45 a.m. March 13th at Plaza Park Oxnard. Later in the day, at 11 a.m., there's a protest at the Government Center. These events are being hosted by the Black Lives Matter Ventura County Chapter. You can find more information at BLM Ventura County on Instagram.
As of March 10th, there are 93 new cases and 8 additional deaths. There are 81% ventilators available and adult ICU bed availability is at 32% throughout Ventura County. Up next, we'll be joined by Adam Fukick to talk about local science.
Living in SoCal, wildfires have become sort of a fact of life for us. We know that season where it gets dry and windy. And then, as in 2020, which was our worst fire season on record, California becomes a front page headline. Most of these articles usually just devolve and turn into guessing about why we get these fires. Well, the causes behind these fires are complex, as well as very important to us. So, for the next few episodes, we're going to tackle them one by one, and hopefully by doing so, we can understand why there are these fires, why they are a grim warning sign for us, and what we can and should do about it. There are many complex causes behind what's going on, and today we'll focus on water, or the lack thereof it. Simi Valley specifically, as well as California in general, gets its water from many different places, the main two sources being from the Sierra Nevadas, and almost exclusively in the south, from the Colorado River. Each one of these sources has been falling short in recent years due to many factors, one of the biggest being global warming. The Sierra Nevadas are a mountain range that separates the San Joaquin Valley, which is to say the Central Valley of California, from the Nevada Desert. The Sierras are one of the most important water sources for the state, and for Los Angeles and Simi as well. During the winter months, it usually gets a lot of snow. Then, during the summers, the snow melts, with most but not all of the water going down the west slopes of the mountains into mainly rivers. Those rivers will go down into the environment, and they'll soak in through little, tiny little streams into the water, and they'll get up into the plants. So the plants will have the water, so they're not as dry, making them a lot less harder to catch on fire. The main rivers that this water flows through are the San Joaquin River and the Sacramento River for the Central Valley, and by way of a bunch of others for the rest of Southern California. But recently, mainly due to higher temperatures, which are due to global warming and mining pollution, we have been getting a lot less snowfall. In the past 100 years, the amount of snowmelt coming off of the Sierras between April and July has decreased by a whopping 42%. That means that the forest in the Sierras, as well as all the land and the plants that water helps keep wet, are going to be that much drier. That dryness makes them especially much more prone to catching on fire. The second place Southern California gets its water from is the Colorado River. Now, the Colorado River gets its water from a basin. A basin is a bunch of smaller waterways such as smaller rivers and streams, in a given area, because they're all going towards the same place, the ocean, they'll run into each other and they'll collect into bigger and bigger rivers until they become one big river. The biggest example I can give is the Amazon River, with many, many small rivers running through the jungles over there, but them all collecting and running into each other until they all form one giant Amazon River. It's the same thing with this Colorado River Basin. Any rain that falls into any of the rivers and streams will end up flowing into the Colorado River. Now, originally, back in my day, the Colorado River ended its journey in the Baja California Gulf. But ever since the creation of the Glen Canyon Dam in the 1960s-ish, it has rarely, if ever, poured any amount of water into the Gulf. Now, this is because of the desert that makes up the basin area is getting hotter and drier with a lot less rain every year due to global warming again, but also due to the damming up of the river in several key places, which causes the river to be stuck behind the dams rather than flowing as they're supposed to. Another factor that's causing the river to not flow as well is because other cities on that river are using a lot more water, such as Las Vegas. So there is a lot less water that is flowing down to keep SoCal as wet as it needs to be to avoid fires. From both sources, the Sierras and the Colorado, the amount of water we have that is not used for factories, farms, and families is shrinking fast. It's making the plants and everything around us a lot drier and a lot easier to burn. This is becoming worse as there are more and more people in California increasingly living in dense cities, which use a lot more water. It's also been made worse by more of that water being diverted up into farms in the central San Joaquin Valley. But all of that is a big web of factors that we'll have to continue untangling in next week's episode. In the meantime, stay curious and remember to tune in next time.
Up next, we'll be joined with some peeps from a program called Spectrum Collaborative. Spectrum is a local organization that pairs LGBTQ+ mentors with young mentees to work on various forms of art in order to build a better sense of community and create a safe space for LGBTQ+ youth in Simi Valley. I've worked with them in high school, and I'm so excited they're joining us today to talk about a new event they're hosting that will uplift our community.
Calling all young queer folks and allies in Ventura County. Do you have a passion for singing?
Are you looking for guidance with your drawing technique?
Maybe you've always wanted to try costume design.
Then you should check out Spectrum Arts Collaborative.
Our mission is to mentor LGBTQIA+ youth and allies through creative expression. We pair participants between 13 and 18 with mentors who have expertise in all kinds of artistic pursuits.
Together, over 12 weeks, mentors help mentees design their own projects, such as paintings, music, podcasts, and more.
Join us for our Spring 2021 session, starting March 25th.
We meet Thursdays over Zoom from 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. through June 17th.
Whether you're interested in participating as a mentee or becoming a mentor, visit us at spectrumcollaborative.org.
Here are some more job opportunities in Simi Valley. Party City is looking for a part-time sales associate. Vaughn's is hiring for a full-time position in the grocery department. Sunrise Senior Living is looking for a full-time associate director of sales. And Big Lots is looking for a part-time store associate.
Here's what's going on in local politics. I don't know who came up with the idea of the Simi Government Focus newsletter, but honestly, I love them to death. I do. The newsletter graphics are so pretty, and it simplifies everything into language that is easy to understand. If you aren't sure what the Simi government-focused newsletter is, basically the Simi Valley government has been sending out newsletters to keep you up to date with what's been going on in the Simi government. The newsletter gives amazing information. You can sign up for the newsletter on our website, RadioSimi.com, under the tab Keep Fighting. If you don't want to sign up, that's okay. We'll start including some of the highlights in our news hit. My only criticism is that it's only offered in English, but I'm sure they have plans for a bilingual newsletter in the future. The Simi Valley Youth Council is having a special meeting on the 16th from 5 to 6 p.m. to discuss youth council recruitment for the 2021 to 2022 term. The Simi Valley Youth Council is just that, a council made up of young people to represent the youth and the issues we're facing. There are representatives from every school in the general community. Applications are accepted all year, but there are deadlines for a specific term. Applications for the next term are being accepted until 5 p.m. on May 21st. You can apply and attend the special meeting through the city's website.
Here are some safety tips. Simi Valley has recently been hit with a rainstorm that has resulted in icy roads, hail, frozen windshields, and more road hazards. We have some tips to help you stay safe while driving in the rain. Make sure to give yourself twice the normal space in front of you. Brake gradually to avoid sliding. Be extra cautious at intersections in case someone can't see you or can't stop. Turn on your headlights, but not brights. And above all, keep your wits about you.
Here are two ways that you can help people struggling financially with medical bills. Unfortunately, one of my good friend's boyfriends was in a horrible car accident. He's now being treated in a nearby hospital. My friend Kat Russo started a GoFundMe for him. The funds go to paying for his surgery, medical bills, and physical therapy. To donate, you can go to gofund.me/44D30D24, or you can click the link on our website, radiosimi.com, under the tab Keep Fighting. One of my extended relatives also passed away two nights ago. Her daughter Zoe is accepting donations to pay for the medical bills and her funeral service. She's still setting up the GoFundMe, but for now you can donate via Venmo. Her handle is Zoey-Koffin. The last four digits of her phone number are 0239.
Next, we'll be joined with local musician Matt Anthony.
Hello, thank you for having me. It's good to be on. It's good to talk, share about myself.
Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
All right, so basically, I grew up kind of like my whole high school year started off in San Jose. I've really been like a music geek kind of most of my life. I've always started off listening to rock stuff and then eventually hearing my mom playing stuff like Eminem and just grew from there. Before I knew it, I kind of started with guitar and then because of things that happened in high school, I just kind of put the guitar down and started focusing more on like writing my music. And just like, I got into rap a lot. And then about junior year and like maybe sophomore year towards the end, I would listen to Juice WRLD finally for like the first time. And I remember my homie had sent me like a couple of his unreleased songs. And from that point on, I just was obsessed with that kind of music. It just blew my mind how people would take like, you know, loops from a rock song and then loop it to a rap beat. And then, you know, they would be rapping. It just, the whole difference in the genre and how it all changed from being, I guess, the whole mumble rap that everybody was making fun of to a new age of rap was just insane to me. And I wanted to hop onto it. And before I knew it, I had producers that were hitting me up trying to send beats. They really liked the sound that I was, you know, trying with, and it took off from there. I've met multiple artists now, is Randy, Six Tails, all people who not too familiar yet because I have songs under the way, on the way soon, so that'll be coming out. But as of now, I have a couple songs released with Randy and one song released with Six Tails, more on the way, and yeah, so.
What's been your biggest inspiration so far?
My biggest inspiration so far, I think, has been between, I think, my first year getting out of high school and seeing how the real world is. And then also, I mean, the obvious truth, like, you know, anybody who listens to my music knows, you know, it sounds a lot like Juice WRLD in a way at times. Juice WRLD was a big inspiration for me just because of how, you know, I idolized his skill and his mindset mostly. He had a very, very just killer mindset, and the way he was with his music and the passion he had for his music, you can tell, you know, you take away the money, he'd still be making music. Like, it was just one of those things that was like his safe place. It was, you know, something that he went to for more than just, you know, a career. It was his life. And that's something that I envy, because it's like, I feel like these days a lot of people in the music industry are doing it for maybe different reasons. And I don't know if I can really respect that personally, but you know what? I mean, chase a bag, do your thing. I just, you know, music has always been more about, you know, what inspires you and it being an art. And I agree that, you know, when you view something as an art, it shouldn't be viewed for the value. It should be viewed for, you know, what you take it at. Another big inspiration, though, as a lot of people know, recently I got out of a kind of toxic relationship, and that was great. I won't disclose too much of that publicly because there's no need to, but I'll just say wish the best of luck to the other party. And, you know, I'll be doing me, she'll be doing her. It's just kind of the way it goes. But, you know, I'm definitely doing pretty good. That's all I got to say. I'm definitely taking it as a positive to improve myself and to use it for my music. And I just want to say, you know, anything I say in my music is all based off of truth. I don't need a cap.
Many of your listeners know that you unreleased an entire album on Valentine's Day. A lot of the songs that you unreleased were very popular. If the album was so successful, what made you want to unrelease the music?
So that kind of takes me back to the whole point of like popularity and how many numbers you do or how much you can sell from something. That's just that's another thing I've always thought about. Like, art should be a reflection of you. And at the end of the day, whatever I put out in my music should be a reflection of me and what I believe in. And, you know, like, I guess my message in a way. So, you know, certain lyrics, as I said, you know, I just got out of a kind of a relationship, and the beginning motivation of my music a lot of the times was that relationship. So my music was shaped a lot around that. Therefore, when that artwork, you know, is saying a certain thing, but I'm believing and I'm feeling a different way, I don't want to have that out anymore, no matter what, you know, kind of income it could, you know, to potentially bring in or how popular it is. Don't get me wrong, I still, you know, those songs I'll always cherish to a certain point because that's my art and that's something I'm proud of. Like, I'll never not be proud of a song I make. I always, like, my rule is if I'm going to release something, it's going to be a banger no matter what. Like, if I can't listen to it, no one else can listen to it. That's just the way I see it. So more getting towards why exactly I unreleased it, though, is because I feel like, you know, again, touching back at the fact that it doesn't show the same message that I'm trying to give now. And in regards to a lot of, like I said, a lot of those songs were about my ex, and it's just straight up, I don't feel that way about her anymore. So I don't want my art to be out there, you know, speaking towards her, putting energy towards her when that's not the situation anymore. You know, it's just, I don't feel comfortable putting that out as a message anymore by myself. I don't feel that way. So, you know, no matter how popular the song may be, no matter how much money it could make, I just, it's not worth it to be conveying that message anymore.
You've been talking a lot about like money not being the motivation for your music. Mm-hmm. So what was your first time in the studio like before, you know, you got signed by and became successful?
So basically, I think, well, it was just really trippy at first because for me, I had to save up a lot. I was still in high school at the time. I remember it was just barely like a week or two into January 2020. And I had no job. I mean, I was out, you know, I was mowing lawns for my mom's friends and shit. It was great. I was mowing lawns for my mom's friends and, you know, cleaning attics, helping move stuff, decorate houses when, you know, holidays were coming up. I was doing anything. I was really thirsty for money because for me, it was just whatever chance I had to record. At the time, I was only even recording for like two or three songs at a time. So I had finally saved up the money. And I remember getting so excited and I was like, great, I can book this studio session. I booked it, everything. And I was like, oh my God, I just booked a session over in downtown LA and I have no car. So like, it was that down bad. Like I wasn't even driving yet. I couldn't get myself there. So then I called my homie, Mike. Shout out Mike. He's doing well. Shout out to Mike's Auto Detailing. but you know, go get your car washed. he has always been a very, very supportive person in my come up as well. Like, we've kind of been hand in hand. He's very more on the entrepreneur side, and I'm more on like the artist or, you know, creator kind of influencer side of business when it comes to not really caring about going to school and really going for it, following your dreams. So he's always understood me, and we've always been kind of hand in hand, always supporting each other, even in the darkest times, you know, even in times where I was confused and I was just like, what's going to go next with music? Like, is this really a career? So there'd be times, you know, where, you know, the first session, you know, he and I are sitting there, I'm recording a song that I barely just wrote a couple months ago and I think is going to go crazy. And one of the craziest things was sitting down with that that engineer who, Darius, shout out Darius, the homie Darius too. We've been working together now for like a year and a half. It's so insane to see the progression of my music from the beginning at Broken Promises, which was the first ever song I recorded in an official studio. Now coming all the way to one of my most recent songs. This is unreleased, but it's a song with Ibra. It's called Closer. And it's like the quality on that mic specifically from going to that private studio and then just being at Golden Impala too is so insane to see the difference in quality. But when it comes to, you know, the first session, it's just going back to it. I really do miss that, because going back to the times where I'm like, damn, is this going to blow up? Like, what is this going to do? I guess being all innocent and just doing it for the for real passion, just seeing how many people are going to hear this song. And then going down the line a year later, this song that I made in, you know, such a tiny session with not a lot of funding to, you know, really do much. It's crazy to see how that one song, like I said, focusing on passion, that was my very first song. And here it is now, like 70,000 streams. It's just crazy to think.
So most people that went to high school with us know that you were sort of obsessed with the military and the Marines for a while. You, including showing up to school dressed in uniform, your obsession switched to music so quickly and so dramatically. So why did you start making music, and how many unreleased songs do you have in the vault?
So it all started because at the time, as I was saying before, when I was younger, I've always been like into music. But the reason why I've always been into music when I was younger is because I've had ADHD since, you know, God knows when. And I've always been very energetic, just bouncing off the walls. I've always needed something that's going to keep me, like, I guess, grounded. Something that's going to keep me, like, with my attention, because I've always been going, you know, 200 miles per hour in my mind. When it comes to that, I was always getting in trouble when I was younger, and that ended up getting me sent to military school. And my mom, as her ultimatum, when I finally, you know, finished up with military school around the end of middle school, her ultimatum was like, okay, you can go back to a normal school, but I still want you doing kind of something structured with military, because it's been keeping you in check. And, you know, you haven't really been bouncing off the walls. And I was like, all right. So we did some looking in, and one of my homies at the time that I was in school with at the military school was doing this program as well called Young Marines. And shout out to Marines. I mean, they really did a lot for me. I guess straightened me up, I guess just giving me some certain values that I have now in life. You know, just the way I function, the way I do certain things in life, you know, the punctuality I have with time, like going to studio sessions, for example. If you go to a studio session with someone like really important, one thing you're going to learn, you don't want to be late. You always want to be early. You really want to kiss up to these people. And I guess certain just things with punctuality, certain things that you learn from, you know, the military that I guess are a little bit more out of pocket, you know, in the real world. But when you apply them in certain scenarios, it really is helpful. And bringing that now, how did I go from the military to music? One day I realized, you know, obviously when I could be, you know, making music, that I've always loved music. I just never put too much attention towards it, and starting to realize, okay, I have this skill that I can pursue. Why would I throw away that skill to do something, I guess, guaranteed? And that's something I've always hated, like how people will throw away their life just for something quick and easy, like something like quick satisfaction. It never made sense to me. It's like, why, when you know you could sacrifice and push the extra mile, why would you settle for less, I guess? And I feel like for me, settling for less would have been just going to the Marine Corps and like doing whatever that I, you know, at the time, everybody else in the Young Marines was doing, you know, just throwing themselves forward, not really knowing what's next. I just didn't like that. I'd rather not know what's next, but know that I'm following my passion and doing something that's going to make me happy at the end of the day. And so when it came to all that, you know, Young Marines did good for me, but, you know, music at the end of the day has always been a passion. Like I said, and I decided to follow it. And now here I am, you know, music's doing great and I'm a happy person. You know, I wake up every day with a smile on my face. I don't have much to complain about because I really do. I love what I do. And I get to wake up every day and write songs and all that. And coming now to how many songs I have in the vault. Recorded, I have about like 20 to 25 songs. Some of them are unmixed. So that's why I say 20 to 25. It's like, it's just, you know, my own thing. Depending on how I feel, how my music's ready and whether I want, you know, the public to hear it or not, it'd be like 20 to 25 songs. But then just written and just in the vault in general, I'd probably say I have about like 200 to 300 songs that are just written and kind of just waiting out there to have something done with them. And again, the reason why I say 200 to 300 is because it's like, I throw around numbers like that because I have so many songs where I start writing and it's like, I don't know if this is finished or not, because, you know, I can come back and add to it. I can come back and change to it. But I'd say roughly 200 to 300 songs are about written and, you know, just ready to record in the vault, and then recorded wise, 20 to 30.
All right. Thank you. I don't have any other questions. Thank you so much for coming on our show, and good luck with your future endeavors.
Of course. Of course. Likewise. I am appreciative of you guys having me on, being willing to hear from me. I'm appreciative of being able to, I guess, share my wisdom and how I feel and share a little bit about what it's like, you know, doing music, I guess, and putting more perspective for those that like to keep up with me. I'll be obviously telling all my fan base to be checking in to this episode. So that'd be great. Anybody who wants to know more about me, I guess, you know, here's a little piece of me shared with you guys.
This song is called Heart Attack. And just a quick disclaimer, it is explicit. So please listen at your own discretion.
Pop another Zan, we'll be gone for the night. We'll be back before the light. Now my mind is going black, trying to find where Shawty at. Yeah, she ripped my heart out, Shawty let me heart attack. Yeah, she grabbed me by the hand, tell me pop another Zan. We'll be gone for the night, we'll be back before the light. Now my mind is going black, trying to find where Shawty at. Yeah, she ripped my heart out, Shawty let me heart attack. Eyes red, lungs burned, more mess, love hurts. I'm dead, love's cursed, my bed, your curse. Making Shawty's legs hurt, making Shawty's bed jerk. I can get her on her knees, but she ain't gon' be my queen. She a baddie for the king, but she a baddie for the team. She a whole damn freak, but she don't belong to me. Love to kiss up on that neck, love to suck it till it's wet. When I whisper in your ear, make you smile from ear to ear. She be tripping, baby dipping, she just keep confusing me. She playing games with my brain, now I think it's killing me. Yeah, she grabbed me by the hand, tell me pop another Zan. We'll be gone for the night, we'll be back before the light. Now my mind is going black, trying to find where Shawty at. Yeah, she ripped my heart out, Shawty let me heart attack. Yeah, she grabbed me by the hand, tell me pop another Zan. We'll be gone for the night, we'll be back before the light. Now my mind is going black, trying to find where Shawty at. Yeah, she ripped my heart out, Shawty let me heart attack. Now she dished me for a loser, cause she fucking with a winner. I hope that bullshit paid off, cause these bands are all I got. I hope it cooks and serves you dinner, hold your hands when you shiver. Rubs his hands right through your hair, nah, I hope she leaves you scared. I just hate this dumb decision, wish it was a big illusion. Cause we had more than any pair and now it's lost among the air. You used to want what we was playing, are you still hoping that it happens? I don't know, but baby, lately things have been too frustrating. She grabbed me by the hand, tell me pop another Zan. We'll be gone before the light, we'll be back before the night. Yeah, she grabbed me by the hand, tell me pop another Zan.
Thank you so much for listening to episode 11 of Radio Simi.
Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Radio Simi.
Remember, if you want us to play your song, share your story, or feature your graphic art, reach out to us at tiny.cc/RadioSimiForum. Don't forget, we're looking for people to join our team, so if you want to help and get to know your community better, fill out the application of interest at tiny.cc/joinRadioSimi. We have multiple positions open, so please apply. We're looking for people to do research content for us to share, someone to write captions for our YouTube to better accommodate people with disabilities, and someone to convert audio file and transfer data on our shared Google Drive. We don't require any experience and we don't have an age limit. Everyone is welcome and encouraged to apply. Thank you so much for listening to episode 11, and I hope you have a great day. See you next week.